Hello, welcome and good morning to our e-learning classes. Today in this very peaceful morning, very calm, serene atmosphere, again we are trying to repeat the fifth poem of 12th standard English medium students, The Roadside Stand. Today I would like to make you very clear about some sort of lines doubts, that why this roadside, the roadside stand. The writer Robert Frost wrote, as I said earlier, Robert Frost, a very realistic poet who is writing his contribution in the history of English literature in a very realistic way, talks about real things that happens surrounding him. And one of the picture of a poor man, though there is no class classification in the human world, the man-made classification is still existing there, and the roadside stand is one of the example of this class classification division in this cosmic world. Why? Because the poor man becomes the poorer and the richer becomes the rich. The rich becomes the richer. Again, if we want to highlight the point about these lines, while greedy good doers, see, there is contradiction in the line. If you read it very silently, you will find here greedy good doers. Now, how can a greedy be a good doers? A greedy person is in need of more things, whatever those things might be. Might be of any particles, might be any object, might be money, might be anything, any vehicle or any material. But he needs a lot. So, greedy good doers. Though they are greedy, how can they be a good doers? And here the good doer word is used for their calculative minds, those who are, you know, making very deceptive schemes, very deceptive schemes with their fertile brain, with their mind. They think that these poor people will be trapped in their web very easily, and in their web very easily. Now this web is the web of the trap that they have made for them to fall in, and that's why it is good doers. They are making plans of these projects, schemes for the welfare of the poor, for the welfare of the farmers. Again, beneficent beasts. See, if we talk about the figures of speech, greedy good doers is an alliteration. Is an alliteration, right? In the same way, beneficent beasts of prey. Again, here the figures of speech is alliteration. Beneficent beasts of prey. Prey are the word again for those people who are against the beneficiary person. Means these are the people, greedy people, who are always, every now and then, planning to lead their life very comfortably. They have set their mind very calculatively to divert and decept and to attract these poor people to fall in the trap of them, and to in this way they are doing nothing but exploitation. Exploitation of their time, their energy, and financially they are not given that much amount of their daily wages. That's what these lines again want to convey, that the poet has tried to make out of it, right? Coming to the next point, that is child's longing. What the poet really wants to convey through this child's longing? Child's longing means every child is longing for something, is dreaming for something, is having some desire very strongly beneath the heart. And how the poet has tried to find out, or how the poet has tried to convey through this child's longing in this poem. Here the poor people are considered poor, and you can say the farmers are considered to be the child. And generally, as usual, we all want to satisfy our every need in our life. In the same way, these poor people are struggling hard. They are struggling to survive. They are struggling to get all those cozy comforts of the world. And what they do? They are in getting all these cozy comforts, they are dreaming about. And here the poor people, the farmer, had made one stand outside the road, roadside stand. In this plan that every passers-by, means those of the passers-by, by the side of the road, will be stopped there and would buy something from him, and he would get a handsome amount of money. But you know how these rich people are. The rich people are very shrewd people. Shrewd people. They need everything. They want those things, but at a low cost and with a quantity, with a handsome quantity, in a low cost. So this waiting farmer or poor person by the roadside is not getting what he really expecting from this rich people, and it is like very heartless. It is like very heartless to him. Means the roadside stand person, poor person, farmer, is struggling to get more from the outer passers-by, but This passers-by proved heartless. Rich person proved heartless. Though they stop there, they don't buy it as they found it very costly or found not as per their expectation. The dream of this poor man, those poor men who is longing for their dreams, are not getting a good handsome amount. These are the moments of despair. These are the moments of gloominess, and their disparity is very troublesome for them, for this poor man. The other person realized the same. The other person who are in the same pain, also feeling the same situation like the poor man, and the rich are also feeling the same for the rich man, because the rich man is very calculative, is in a very thoughtful calculation, not buying anything stuff from this poor man. So the poor man is in despair. He is deeply hurt. He is deeply hurt. And that is what the child's longing that the poet is really want us to convey through this poem. So in a brief, we can say that poor people, those who are roadside people, struggling people, are getting no more as per their dreams and wish and will for which they are longing. On the contrary, they are being exploited by this rich, fertile brain people who are calculating every scheme project very deceptively, and in this way they prepare a trap for their prey, like this poor man. That is what the roadside stop by Robert Frost. I hope that you must have understood both this explanation very easily and comfortably. Prepare all these questions and multiple choice type of questions and figures of speech, particularly in this poem, the figures of speech repetition and alliteration are being used alternatively. Thank you very much.